Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome to the What a Deck profile for the Dinomist Beatdown deck. I'm just going to run through all the cards that are in here real quick, and then I'll explain their role in the deck. So we've got three of every Dinomist currently available. That's three Rex, three Ceratops, three Brachion, three Petron, or Terran, three Plesios, three Stegosaurer. Yeah, and three Stegosaur. We're also running three Yu-Gi-Saki. We're running three Terraforming, three Pendulum Storm, two Emergency Teleport, three Dinomist Charge, three Dynamic Power Load, two Dinomist Rush, and three Pendulum Reborn. For the extra deck, we've got Scarlight Red Dragon Archfiend. I know they changed his name. Ignister Prominence, the Blasting Draco Slayer, Blood Mesfit, Dark Strike Fighter, Odd Eyes Meteor Burst Dragon, Clearwing Synchro Dragon, Black Rose Moonlight Dragon, Black Rose Dragon, Wind Up Arsenal Zen Mayo, Number 61 Volcasaurus, Dark Rebellion Ixie Dragon, Number 106 Giant Hand, Number 103 Ragna Zero, Number 82 Heartland Draco, and Castell, the Sky Blasting Musketeer. The side deck I'll go over later once I explain the deck. Basically, this is just a beatdown deck. You've got a lot of big attacking monsters, and you pendulum summon. This is really a deck that you just want to barf everything that you have onto the field, for the most part, and just attack away with it. You've got two scales, a 6 and a 3, that all the Dinomist fall into one of those two categories. Every 6 has the effect that before resolving a card effect that targets another Dinomist card you control, you can negate that effect and destroy this card. And the 3 say if another Dinomist card you control would be destroyed by battle or an opponent's card effect, you can destroy this card instead. So, like I said, it's just a beatdown deck, and then those effects are just there to give them a little added survivability. If they try to, like, 101, you can stop them from being targeted. If they Dark Hole Raigeki, you can blow up your Pendulum Scale instead. And then helping that is Dinomist Charge. This is your search card, but it's also a continuous spell. So when you activate it, you add one Dinomist card from your deck to your Dinomist monster from your deck to your hand. And then once per turn, if a Dinomist card would be added from your field to your extra deck, you can add it to your hand. So that's really good. One of the bad downsides of pendulums in general is if your pendulum scale gets blown up, it goes to the extra deck, and if you can't rebuild that pendulum scale, they're just kind of useless there in the extra deck. But with this, if, like I said, if they activate Raigeki, you can blow up your scale 3, and then instead of just going to the extra deck, it comes back to your hand. This is like once per turn during either player's turn, so that's during your opponent's turn, during your turn. The only downside to this card is that it's mandatory. Whatever is the first thing to get blown up is what you have to add back. And if you get more than one of them, because they're mandatory, they just go on a chain link together. And you don't get two effects, you just get to add one card back. Other than that, as far as monster effects, Rex is your biggest beater. He's got 2400. He also has the best effect. You can tribute another Dinomist when he attacks, or after he attacks, and you can either attack another monster again in a row and do piercing damage, or shuffle one card from your opponent's hand or field into the deck, and then gain 100 attack. So, obviously, if they just got a bunch of defensive wall, or they got a marshmallow, you can just attack again in a row, keep doing piercing damage. Otherwise, you're just shuffling stuff back into their hand. So you always want to attack last with him, get all their damage, and then you can use him and tribute one of the ones that already attacked. Ceratops and Brachion are the least useful. They've got 2100 and 2000 attack respectively, and really their only effect is if you have another Dinomist, you can summon this guy, and if your opponent controls the monster with the highest attack and you don't have another one of these, you can summon him. So these are just special summonable. They're level 5s, but they don't have a whole amount of attack. They're mostly, if you're going to use Pendulum Scales, use these. Petron is second most useful. When he destroys a monster by battle, you can add a Dinomist card from your deck to your hand. That includes Charge, and you almost always want to get Charge. You can also get Rust or Rush. This is not a Dinomist card, though, so you can't add that. Even though it helps Dinomist, it doesn't have Dinomist in the name. Plesios, while he's on the field, all your opponent's monsters lose 100 attack and defense for each Dinomist card you control. So with him in a Pendulum Scale, that's 300. If you get a full field, you can really lower their attack a lot, so he's pretty useful. He's also got a mean 1700 just on his own, which even lowering their attack is... he's a decent beatstick. And finally, Stegosaur. Stegosaur is when a pendulum monster you control battles an opponent's monster, after damage calculation, you can destroy both monsters. Another pendulum. So it doesn't work with him, but if you get him out and anything else, whatever they attack, if they don't attack him, then you can destroy their monster too. So these all have their utility in certain aspects, and then he's your big beat stick, and these are usually either beat sticks or just your pendulum scale. So I got Ghost Ogre and Snow Rabbit. That's just a tuner. I went with her because you got emergency teleport. You could just bring it in and synchro for 7 and 8, because all your monsters are level 5 and 4, so the 3-star just works really well. Effect Veiler might work almost as well if you wanted to get rid of those. Terraforming, just to get the field spell. The field spell's not amazing, but it does enough. It gives all your Dinomists 300 attack, and when they attack, your opponent cannot activate cards or effects until the end of the damage step, which means no Honest and none of those new mirror forces. And I found it was just enough to worry about that I put this in here. The Terraforming is just deck thinning because you don't really need anything else. Pendulum Storm. Destroy as many cards in each player's pendulum zones as possible, then destroy one spell trap. I probably wouldn't recommend this. I was just playing it in this deck to try to be a little different because I'd use Twin Twister. Twin Twister actually probably work better in this deck, as would like Galaxy Cyclone or even just MST almost, unless you're playing against pendulums. If you're playing against pendulums, this is a really good card, but you don't really want to destroy your pendulum scales most of the time, and you have to have at least one. So if your opponent's not playing pendulums, you're just blowing up your own cards for no reason. And I think that's about it. We got Dinomist Rush. Special summon a Dinomist from your deck. It's unaffected by other cards and effects and destroyed during the end phase. I only run this at 2 because this can be good and bad, obviously, because it's a trap. It can save you in certain situations, especially because that monster's unaffected by other card effects, so it can survive being like Black Rosed or something along those lines. Of course, it goes to the extra deck because it's destroyed at the end phase. So if you don't have your scales or your scales get blown up, you're not really in much of a situation. It's a good search. It's just if you don't have your scales set up, it's not helping you very much. And finally, Pendulum Reborn. I'm surprised this isn't used more. I guess other decks are fast enough, but this is special summon a face-up pendulum monster from your extra deck or graveyard. This is really good if your scales get blown up. You can summon one of these back. You can also summon one from the graveyard if you Ixie summon. Just decent overall. It's almost always useful. Even if you just get one monster in this, at least you can bring something back. Most of the extra deck, it's just odd. I basically just picked the best level 7s and level 8s. This guy obviously can blow up anything with less than 3,000. This guy is great, especially against other pendulum decks, because you can shuffle one card. Blood Mesfit is here to do burn damage. I like to have basically a Gagaga cowboy if I can. I couldn't fit one for the rank 4s, and I hardly ever made a rank 4. So I put this guy in here. He could sometimes burn for game. Same with Darkstrike Fighter. Meteor Burst is just a good attack. Clearwing Synchro is probably the best defensive synchro you can make, at least for level 7. Just because he can shut down. Certain decks can't really deal with Clearwing Synchro, like Lightsworns and stuff. Moonlight Rose Dragon, really useful in certain situations just for sending one card back, especially things that can't be destroyed. And of course Black Rose, because why not Black Rose? And we've got the rank 5s. Of course got Zen Mayo, he can blow up 2 cards. Volcasaurus can blow up, he can win a game, burn damage. Dark Rebellion, and the rest of these are just stapled. Just staples. You can throw whatever you want in here. Which finally just brings us to the side deck. These are just other options, other things to consider with this deck. There's a couple actual side deck cards, but I'll get to them when I get to them. Performapal Camelump. I had him here originally because your monsters get their effects when they attack. He can be a good idea for a pendulum because he can make your opponent's monsters lose 800 defense and make a monster you have do piercing damage. He's also scale 2. So he works with, you can swap him out for Ceratops, because he's not really all that useful or essential to the deck. Scrap Dragon's just another level 8. More stuff you can make, because these are all water monsters, you can make Gungnir, although usually you don't have the card advantage in your hand to really take advantage of that effect. You can't make Cyber Dragon Infinity in this, because you have level 5 machine monsters. I don't like Cyber Dragon Infinity, so I don't use him, but that's just personal preference. If you want to make the best deck, I would just put him in there. Likewise, Tyrus, Keeper of Genesis, probably more useful than, like, Zen Mayo, just for certain situations. Same with Crystal Zero against certain decks. This is one of the few decks I'd actually advocate putting, like, a couple cards in the side deck, a couple extra deck cards in the side deck. Just because, like, you don't have enough room between the Synchros and the Ixies for stuff like 101, because he's sort of fallen out of favor, just getting rid of one monster. You would normally, Castell can do the same thing. But, you know, against certain decks, he's really good. Raigeki and Darkhold, you have to be a fool not to play them, especially in Pendulums, because you're a monster, especially if you're not playing against Pendulums, because then you're just getting free stuff. Ignite Reload, pretty good card, especially if you play some of the other Pendulums in here. Basically, you could shuffle all the Pendulum monsters in your hand into the deck, and then draw cards equal to the number you sent, plus one. So he's a little bit decent, like, deck thinning, and it helps for if you get, like, all your six scales, or all your three scales, and you need to reset. Another Dinomist Rush. Extra Buck. This is an interesting draw power. I found it was a little slow, but every time a card is added from your extra deck, added to your extra deck, put a spell counter on this. You can send this card with three spell counters to draw two cards. Because you're tributing stuff, because your monsters often get sent back, and you're cycling through with Dinomist Charge, this can actually be decent draw power if you can keep it out long enough. And then finally, because you've got water monsters, you can use Spiritual Water Art Oi. It's one of my favorite. I originally making this more of a deck, card advantage deck, but I found it didn't really work very well. But this is a decent card regardless. If you wanted to make this more card advantage-wise, throw this in here. And Aquarium Stage. Water monsters you control cannot be destroyed by battle with other non-water monsters. If you're facing off against another, like, big beatdown deck, or something with just massive, massive attack point monsters, this could be an excellent stall card. I would recommend this in the side deck. These two good side deck cards, kind of a good side deck card, and then some of these extra deck cards, maybe Raigeki. Everything else is just other options you might want to consider with your build. So there you go. There's your profile. Sorry it went a little bit long, but there's a lot of stuff to explain. Next week I'll be back with, hopefully, Infernoids. Until then, good luck, and have fun.